CNN correspondent Chris Cuomo was accused of sexual harassment by his former boss at ABC in an op-ed she penned for the New York Times.
People who say they are victims should be believed. And you have to know that women don't come forward often and for good and painful reason. We see women get dragged through this process all the time.
Cuomo allegedly hugged his former boss at a going away party, put one hand on her butt, and said that he was allowed to do that now that she was no longer his boss. Chris Cuomo sent an email apology to her the very next day. However, the apology is quite bizarre, and he apologizes to her husband before he ever apologizes to her. Chris Cuomo's brother, Andrew Cuomo, recently stepped down from his position as governor of New York for his own sexual harassment allegations.
A damning report from the state attorney general, which found Cuomo sexually harassed at least 11 women and created a, quote, hostile work environment for women.
Governor Cuomo sexually harassed current and former state employees in violation of both federal and state laws. The independent investigation found that Governor Cuomo sexually harassed multiple women, many of whom were young women, by engaging in unwanted groping, kisses, hugging, and by making inappropriate comments. The governor and his senior team took actions to retaliate against at least one former employee for coming forward with her story, her truth.
I'm Rayy Vana, and welcome back to Rebel HQ. Chris Cuomo advised his brother Andrew not to give in to the allegations or cancel culture and to push back against them, leaving people wondering, how will he respond to his own allegations?
The governor's office confirming what the Washington Post first reported, that Chris Cuomo joined strategy calls with the governor's aides about how to respond to the scandal.
Chris Cuomo gave a lot of advice on these calls. He struck a fairly pugilistic tone, telling his brother to not resign, to push back against the allegations, to not give in to quote-unquote cancel culture.
In a statement, CNN says it was inappropriate for Chris to be on those calls.
Day would come when he would have to be held to account, and I can't do that.
Now that the day has come that it is Chris Cuomo who needs to be held to account, will he be able to do that? For Chris Cuomo's accuser, accountability would not look like Chris Cuomo being fired. Rather, it would look more like him acknowledging what he did and using it as an opportunity to educate himself and his viewers on the harms of workplace sexual harassment and the unfortunate reality that many women have to endure. A study found that 81% of women have suffered some form of workplace sexual harassment.
It's blue collar, it's white collar. It's differing income levels. It is literally every day, everywhere. 75% of women do not report it.
Chris Cuomo has an opportunity to hold himself accountable. And not just that, he also has a massive platform that he can use to educate others on what that accountability looks like and to educate others on the real-world harm caused by workplace sexual harassment.